Millions of people in the Northeast are digging out today after some places were hit with the biggest snowstorm in years. Nearly 70 million Americans have been affected by this blizzard. The storm caused thousands of power outages and flight cancellations. It also forced several coronavirus vaccine sites in multiple states to shut down. The storm also brought flooding that's more typically seen in hurricane season and not February. CBS News' Elise Preston reports from New York City.
Snowplow crews are working around the clock to keep roads clear throughout the Northeast.
We can get walloped with 22 inches of snow, and people want their daily life and daily routine to return immediately. That's not always possible.
More than 2 feet of snow has fallen in some places, like here in New Jersey.
Almost as soon as we plow it, it's covered again. So we have to stay on top of it constantly.
With more to come today.
I am actually out because I'm about to buy a snowblower.
Officials want all non-essential personnel to stay off the roads.
If you don't need to be out, go back to your house immediately. If you're in your house, don't leave your house.
Here in New York City, coronavirus vaccine appointments have been canceled and schools are fully remote for a second straight day.
This ball game's not over. We expect a lot more snow before this is over.
Times Square is blanketed with snow. Some New Yorkers found creative ways to get around. And while it was all fun and games for many,
we had such a wonderful 2020. This was a great way to kick off 2021.
The storm did also cause hundreds of accidents. In Connecticut, two people had to be rescued after their truck slid into a pond. This fire truck in Virginia rolled over while responding to an emergency call, injuring the four firefighters inside. And police on the Jersey Shore helped this woman escape the floodwaters that surrounded her home. Elise Preston, CBS News, New York.
For more on this, I want to bring in CBS News meteorologist and climate specialist Jeff Berardelli. Jeff, it's still snowing outside my window here. I'm sure you're seeing the same thing where you are. What is the latest on this storm?
Yeah, we knew this would be a long-haul event, but the good news is the second part of the storm is just snow showers and snow flurries. It's not as heavy, at least around New York City. I'm looking out my window, and yeah, flurries just returned after about a six-hour break, so this is the engine that really could, because it just keeps going. But as you can see, a lot of the precipitation, and most of it's in the form of snow, it's kind of breaking up. But still, some places will pick up probably another inch of snow in some of these bands, and this whole thing is going to kind of swing out to the east over the next 24 hours, and then will we finally be done with this storm. But look at how much snow is on the ground. So we're going to put this in motion for you. And the real bullseye, the heaviest snow is across especially northeast New Jersey into Pennsylvania as well. So take a look at that bullseye. That's over 2 feet of snow. So 20 to 32 inches. Some places will probably not quite get to 36, which would be 3 feet, but almost. In New York City, about 18 inches of snow. Long Island, 6 to 12. Same thing along coastal Connecticut. Further inland you go, you get a little bit more snow. Central New Jersey, you know, that was the bullseye in northern New Jersey as well. But kind of zooming out, now Boston didn't get tremendous amounts of snow because it was mixed with some sleet and rain there, but you go inland and there was more. And this was from lake effect snow. So that bullseye around the Tug Hill Plateau wasn't necessarily all of this system. It was mainly lake effect snow before that. All right, so what's going to be happening over the next, you know, week or so? Well, because of an atmospheric phenomenon called the sudden stratospheric warming, we're going to see some really pretty squirrely weather for the next couple of weeks. Big plunge of Arctic air is going to come. So first of all, let's show you how this storm is going to be exiting. So this is going to be heading to the east and is pretty much going to be gone as we head into tomorrow morning. But you can see these flurries kind of hanging around through the morning, and then it's a thing of the past. But look at this storm right here in Chicago on Thursday. So it'll be rain and snow around Chicago. To the north of that, it's snow. To the south of that, it's rain. Not a big deal. But what it is an Arctic front, some really brutal air. So by Saturday morning, wind chills here in Minnesota and Wisconsin, negative 30, negative 40, negative 50. That's how cold it's going to feel. Maybe negative 20-ish around Chicago. Then what may happen is another storm could form here, and we'll take it out to Sunday and Monday. There's a chance another snowstorm could form around the eastern seaboard. Very early to tell. It may miss, it may hit, but the bigger impact from this system is going to be opening the floodgates to brutal Arctic air, which is going to move from the upper Midwest through the Great Lakes into the Northeast as we head towards Monday, with everybody, you know, in the eastern part of the nation experiencing brutal Arctic air. So winter is just beginning, unfortunately, for us.
Oh, boy. All right. Jeff Berardelli, thank you so much.